ASMR for Tiedz. So I got an oddly specific request to do a ASMR whisper in class tapping. As you can see, I brought some props. Mad props, by the way, to Lahaxi. It's spelled just how it sounds. Showing me support, whether it's one, whether it's five, whether just get so much love from all you guys out there. It's really pleasant and it's nice and I'm grateful for it. So thanks again. Onward to the team. So this worry, that won't be the last time I tap. Tap on the glass. And then look through it. You know, JoJo, and I know a ton of other ASMR artists do it, but I only follow a handful of other artists, as can be seen on the ASMR Buddy. Actually, it's not that weird that you'd want more of a visualization effect along with the tapping. I love the sound of that wood. Actually, a little side note. I never realized how often the phrase "let's find out" is actually used. I think I just thought of it because it's what I say a lot when I'm interested in something, you know, and talking to someone else. Other than the rare moments when I do talk to myself, which is normal, right? But horsing around. So the other night I saw actually has his own show called Let's Find Out. I thought it was funny. And then I think I heard Jordan Peterson say it in an interview. And so I literally got my phone out and started making notes. So I don't know if I find like 10 or more instances. I might have to go back and make a nice little compilation video. I don't know to what end, but it would be kind of fun. So, the history of tea. Well, we have to start with prehistory in China because, naturally, tea, as far as we know it, it starts off with a cheesy opening line. Tea's origin story is infused with a blend of myth and fact, and colored by ancient concepts of spirituality and philosophy. According to Chinese legend, the history of tea began in 2737. 1737 BCE, BC, when the Emperor Shen Nong, a skilled ruler and scientist, accidentally discovered tea while boiling water in the garden. Sorry, I completely forgot that I had some. it's not a cough drop. Go see ASMR to go if you want that. During this period, Chinese culture significantly influenced and impacted our politics and religion in the Far East. Saicho is credited with introducing tea to Japan. While studying in China, Saicho discovered tea and brought back seeds to grow at his monastery. Over time, other monks followed suit, and soon small tea plantations sprouted up at secluded monasteries all over Japan. However, due to the isolation of these plantations, tea's popularity in Japan did not blossom, unlike the flowers, until the 13th century. The most profound, the most popular method, nothing like screwing up a word while I'm trying to whisper in your ear, right, of preparing tea involved grinding Zen monk Aisai. Matcha now is prepared with bamboo whisks or chasen, as they're called, and served in handcrafted bowls or chawan. Don't worry, I don't expect you to remember all these. You're not going to be quizzed later. But I would be curious if you have a dream about a chawan. Skipping forward a couple hundred years now, in the Ming Dynasty, around 1368, actually a 300-year period, all the way to 1644. It wasn't until now that the tea was prepared by steeping the whole leaves in water, like it is today. I just saw a comment though saying that it's a slight disservice to the topic of the video when I pause for obvious trigger tapping and whatnot breaks. So if I can find a way to more fluidly insert it into the video, I will. So I'm trying to tap, but I guess I could talk while I do this. I don't want to just stop talking completely, just so I can tap for a few minutes, because yeah, that is kind of, it's like a kind of a harsh juxtaposition. Well, not harsh, it's ASMR, so that'd be hard to be harsh while being quiet and whispering, but some artistry, I suppose, I should say. It was not until the Ming Dynasty that it was prepared like it is today, steeping the whole leaf, and instead of Chinese monk brought this new rolled tea with him during his travels to Japan in the 17th century. At the end of the Ming Dynasty, shortly thereafter, tea merchants in Kyoto by the name of Soen Nagatini, I guess I'm able to do this after all, invented a new Japanese method of steaming. Drying and rolling green tea during the 18th century. This process and type of tea became known as Sencha and is now a mainstay in Japanese. Sums it up for tea in the east. Now it's migrated a little west towards the setting sun. The discovery of tea in the west. Missionaries and explorers traveling back and forth between Europe and the Orient, East Asia, became exposed to the budding tea traditions in China and Japan around the 9th century. References in Arab trade documents refer to the process of boiling bitter tea leaves. Later, Marco Polo, from 1254 to 1324, alludes to his discovery of tea in his travel writings about the East. Interesting. So tea for Western culture is only, 800 years is a lot, but it's still relatively recent. So tea didn't make a lasting appearance in the West until the 17th century. A Portuguese missionary is attributed with bringing tea to Europe, while established itself, the company did, as the dominant trading power and would go on to monopolize the tea trade with China. Trading stations sprung up in India, including hubs in Bombay, Bengal, and Madras. The company, acting as an imperial arm of England, would exercise users. What do you call those people? Initial users. I always get caught up on stupid words. The primary adopters, early adopters. I think that was the phrase I was looking for. But it's interesting. At the same time, the British, created a dense political environment in America, resulting in dissent and popularization of the notion of no taxation without representation amongst the colonies. Political tensions came to a climax with the Boston Tea Party. Clippers back and forth between China and England, bringing the best teas tea merchant from abroad had intended to provide visitors with free hot tea samples. However, due to the unusually hot weather, it was not a big hit. To promote sales, he asked a nearby ice cream vendor for some ice, which he dumped in the brewed tea. Ain't that such a random act? And then the American iced tea tradition was born. That's 80% of America's sales today. I drink iced tea a lot. Actually, I drink hot tea more, but I grew up drinking iced tea, certainly. I'm curious if you guys do, too, drink iced tea. But the original tea bags were handmade, hand-stitched muslin or silk bags, much like the Mighty Leaf's handcrafted artisan tea pouches. Patents for tea bags existed as early as 1903. However, Thomas Sullivan, merchant from New York, is credited for having the first commercial tea bag concept. Today, tea is the world's most popular beverage after water. Surprise, it's not beer. After Mighty Leaf Tea. Oh, this is a advert for a tea company. This far. We proudly carry on centuries-old traditions by packing our artisan handcrafted tea bags with unique, one-of-a-kind whole leaf blends, herbs, and spices from around the world. Hello, congratulatory oomph was a little preemptive. And that does it, guys. Well, actually, I hope you enjoyed this. Serious thank you to all my subscribers and all those likes and comments. I feel like it seems like they don't get noticed sometimes, but I promise you, with me at least, they do. I look at it all the time, and although I don't comment right away because I'm usually busy, I try to make a point to comment to each and every one of you guys, so make a point to, be sure to comment if you liked my video or if you have some feedback. I love honest, sincere feedback, whether it's bad or good. As long as it's sincere, that's what counts in my book. So with that, check out my Instagram and Twitter. Follow me, guys, if you want some updates or just want to chat privately on there. We're in a more or less topic-centric. Satisfying.